Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Acting Administrator Robert Lightfoot was in Kazakhstan on July 28 to observe the launch to the International Space Station of our astronaut Randy Bresnik with his crewmates Sergey Ryazanskiy of Roscosmos and Paolo Nespoli of the European Space Agency. The trio is scheduled to spend more than 4 months on the station working on hundreds of science and technology experiments. We released new video of astronaut Jack Fisher that was captured during a spacewalk outside the space station in May 2017. The footage, which is available in ultra-high definition, includes the view from a small camera attached to Fisher's spacesuit to give you an idea of what astronauts see when you're looking at them through the lens of a camera operated from inside the station. We participated in the Experimental Aircraft Association's 2017 AirVenture Event during the week of July 24th in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Those in attendance had an opportunity to learn about technologies from across the agency, including our progress developing experimental or X-planes and other aircraft, work aboard the International Space Station, Earth science, the solar system, and our plan for sending astronauts to deep space destinations, including Mars. During the total solar eclipse on August 21, 2017, a team of NASA-funded scientists aboard two retrofitted WB-57F jets will use telescopes mounted on the planes to capture the clearest images of the sun's outer atmosphere, or corona, to date. They will also capture the first ever thermal images of Mercury to study how temperatures vary across that planet's surface. The eclipse is a rare opportunity to learn more about the sun and its effects on Earth's upper atmosphere. On July 25th, engineers at our Stennis Space Center in Mississippi conducted a successful test of the third RS-25 engine flight controller. The flight controller helps the engine communicate with our space launch system, the world's most powerful rocket. Four RS-25s will help power the SLS on its inaugural flight with the Orion spacecraft known as Exploration Mission 1. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.